For more videos on people's struggles, please subscribe to our YouTube channel.
After 10 days of protest, students of the Jamia Milia Islamia University in New Delhi, India, won a victory against the administration. The campus had earlier witnessed massive repression as students were beaten up by goons, who they alleged were supported by the administration. People's Dispatch spoke to some of the students who were involved in the protest.
On the 5th of October, Faculty of Architecture from Jamia conducted a program in which Israel was a country partner. So, concerned students of Jamia, including me, there were 7 to 8 students who held peaceful, I repeat this word, peaceful, who held peaceful protest displaying their placards against the Israel.
So we being the students of a minority status, and we know how Israel has always been a war criminal state and has been oppressive towards Palestine, we boycotted the event and a few students protested for it.
So we didn't want to disrupt anyone, we didn't want to disrupt the program, we were just peacefully protesting against this whole invitation. And what happened after this?
When we were protesting, few men from the proctorial team came and took two of our cadres to their proctorial team in the car, and they manhandled them. They were beaten up, our two cadres were beaten up, and they were locked inside the proctorial office.
Many of our female cadres were also like assaulted. So after that, what happened? Five of our friends got show cause notice. Not only show cause notice, their parents were threatened. Like there was a sense of mental harassment. And when we went to sit in, we wanted to initiate a conversation, because we are the students of this university and the administration has to listen to us. So this is the 10th day, and yesterday on the 9th day, you know, like the most disgraceful and the most disgraceful event of the whole issue that happened on yesterday, that is the 9th day of the protest, is that when including 700 of the students, when we were sloganing here against the VC and against this show cause notice, a group of 25, 30 or approx 40 students came. I would like to call them goons. Like, there were the people from Jamia as well, there were people from locality as well. They were pre-planned and they started beating us.
We were sitting there, we were not participating at that protest till that time. We are just supporting them. We are just seeing that protest that's going on, and there is English department seminar also going on there. Then we were just sitting having a tea. At that time we saw that the group of people came, they are very fit bodies, and they are throwing flower pot towards the protest. Then at that time me and my friend Faiza, we both opened the camera, mobile camera, and we started to shoot. We were shooting all things. We didn't stop our camera. We were going there and here to shoot the full what's going on there. And at that time, one boy saw that we were shooting, and they destroyed one guy's phone also. And two phone, I think. Yeah, they thrown to the floor and that destroyed, I think. Then they came to know that we were shooting, and one guy climbed on the car and he jumped onto the group. We were there. And at that time he got my hand and he snatched my hand. He want to mobile phone that was in my hand, and I get my phone into my dress. Then at that time he's trying to take out that from my dress. Then he dragging me on the floor at that time. And he dragged it to, I think, till the VC office. He dragged it like a dog, and I did bite on his hand, and he left the hand. Then one guy came with a red shirt, I think. One guy came and he beaten with the belt. I were on the floor and he beaten with the belt on my neck. Still I have pain here. Then all protestants came together towards them. At that time they left the campus, and I think God also helped them to get out of the campus.
The recently concluded protests of students in Jamia University, where they achieved all their demands, are very significant, and it's important that the kind of issues they put forward are understood by the civil society and students' movements across India. India and Israel for the last 4-5 years, especially since this regime, have only come closer in terms of various ties, economic, cultural and defense. India is the biggest importer of Israel's arms across the world. We've seen in the last few months how how Israel's model is being transposed over Kashmir. So it's important to oppose these ties at that larger level, and also very importantly then all these ties end up financing Israel's occupation over Palestine. The arms we buy, the other business relations, they all support the occupation, colonialism and apartheid of Israel. And to cover up what Israel actually does against Palestinians and how it breaks international law, it has a very well established project of Brand Israel. Under this project, Israel really seeks to host events, sponsor events which are academic and cultural across the world. This has been recognized especially by Palestinian movements, and in 2004 the Palestinian Campaign for Academic and Cultural Boycott of Israel gave the call that joint efforts which are with the State of Israel or its representative agencies must be boycotted. And in fact, what the students of Jamia have done have actually upheld that very important moral principle in supporting the Palestinian struggle for freedom, justice and equality. And it's important that what the students of Jamia have achieved in their campaign is emulated across the country, because Israel is going to continue hosting and sponsoring such events so that it can whitewash its crimes against Palestinians. It's very important to oppose them, to support the Palestinian freedom struggle, and also to hold our own values of secularism, democracy and freedom of expression.